About 2 weeks ago, Apple refreshed the 5K iMac with new processors, graphics, RAM, and I called it the iMac Pro Killer. Was I right? Can this i9 iMac with Vega graphics compete with a $5,000 iMac Pro? To give you a spoiler, yes, and it's actually faster in some ways. We'll be taking a look at photos and video editing, gaming performance, connections, and more. Check out the description for links to both of these machines along with my personal recommendations. Let's start out with prices. If you spec these Macs as closely as possible, there's only a $750 difference. But the beauty of the standard iMacs is that you can have way more flexibility when ordering one. So if you don't need a 1TB SSD, you're not forced to buy one. You can also upgrade the RAM yourself without voiding your warranty, which could save you up to $680. I'll leave links to the RAM that we used and our easy install guide down below. If you're comparing these two, you likely need performance but are on a budget, so we think that the configuration we purchased makes the most sense. You have an 8-core CPU with Vega 48 graphics and a price savings of around $1,600. On the exterior, the design is practically the same, other than the space gray color of the Pro, which to be honest looks really nice. You also get matching peripherals with a full-size keyboard. The displays are identical, which isn't a bad thing. The 5K resolution is still stunning and it's quite bright with great color accuracy. At the top, the webcam is better on the iMac Pro, being 1080p instead of 720, and along with that, the iMac Pro has better speakers as well. Moving to the back, the iMac Pro no longer has access to RAM, meaning you can't easily upgrade it yourself, but because of that, we have dual fan cooling, which may not make a huge difference with the 8 cores, but you definitely need that if you're gonna buy an iMac Pro with 18 cores. One thing that could make your purchasing decision for you is the I/O. The iMac Pro has double the Thunderbolt 3 ports and 10 gigabit Ethernet built in. Now, not everybody needs these ports. In fact, some won't use them at all, but for others, having two Thunderbolt 3 ports could be quite limiting, especially because the only way to add a 10 gigabit Ethernet to the standard iMac is with a Thunderbolt adapter, meaning you could be left with just one port. Along with that, the SD card reader in the iMac Pro supports faster UHS 2 speeds. Both processors in these machines have 8 cores and 16 threads, but the clock speed on the i9 regular iMac is higher, up to 5 GHz instead of 4.2, which leads us to Geekbench 4 CPU test, where the 2019 iMac has a 25% higher single core score. This shows how it will perform with simple single core tasks, so it could actually feel more snappy day to day. Looking at multi-core, the i9 iMac scores about 8% higher, showing off its power when pushing all the cores. In Cinebench R15, which is a rendering benchmark that pushes all the cores to their max, the scores are similar, but the 2019 iMac still comes out ahead. These results are impressive to me, seeing how this iMac with an unchanged single cooling fan design is beating the iMac Pro. But what about the graphics? Clearly, the Vega 56 in the iMac Pro is a higher tier card than the Vega 48. In Geekbench 4, the iMac Pro scores 20 to 25% higher with the OpenCL and Metal tests. Now, you shouldn't buy either one of these machines for gaming, but say you want to have some fun after the work is done. We tested Unigine Heaven's Extreme preset, and the iMac Pro had only about a 5% higher FPS. In real-world gaming, that's a very small difference, and both of these can perform quite well with higher settings under bootcamp at 1440p resolution. Check out our dedicated gaming video if you want to see what performance you can get in real games. Now, let's jump into photo editing. We tested using Adobe's Lightroom Classic, and both machines perform very well as they should when you're editing. Importing 50 raw 42 megapixel images, the standard iMac is slightly faster. Generating one-to-one previews, the iMac Pro is a few seconds faster, and exporting all 50 raw edited photos to JPEGs took basically the same amount of time. If you edit photos, there's practically no difference. Now let's jump into video editing, and believe it or not, the standard 5K iMac was 13% faster overall when I averaged out all of the tests and all of the programs that I tested. If you edit standard 4K H.264 footage, the i9 iMac is an overall better value, especially in Premiere Pro. But if you're starting to work with H.265 footage, the iMac Pro jumps a ways ahead because of its T2 chip, which the 2019 iMac doesn't have. As far as editing smoothness, both are fantastic overall. The graphics cards seem to render stabilization and effects very similarly in the real world, which is surprising. This is a very difficult topic since the results can vary so much based on your editing program and even the files you work with. So if you want to see which one is faster for your use case and why, check out our full detailed video editing comparison after this video. The iMac Pro is a really nice machine. I love the color, the fact that it has more ports and updated speakers. It's definitely the nicer all-in-one, but it's also a very expensive machine. Now that Apple went from offering at most a 4-core i7 all the way up to a 5 GHz 8-core i9 along with more powerful graphics, I feel that for most, the standard iMac provides such a great value. Unless you need the extra ports, the 2019 i9 iMac provides fantastic performance, which is actually better overall than the iMac Pro at a much lower price. And I think for most people, it's the better choice. Thank you guys for watching. If you want to see more videos like this one, click the little circle above and check out our dedicated gaming and video editing comparisons right over here.